what's up guys, my name is Skylar. So I'm finally done with exams and I can finally sit down and film a video. You know, like growing up, I've always been a huge music fan. Like I've got so many music in my folders. A single phone wouldn't suffice. Like I have to buy a separate iPod Touch just to keep all of my music because my music is like 26, 27 gigabytes. The collection was there since middle school. So you could see how much time I've got to build up my music collection. I think music is a beautiful thing because the music, the lyrics, the melodies, you could connect with it. And for me, sometimes when I listen to a song and when the lyrics speak to me, that song will immediately go to my playlist and I just want to listen to it over and over again. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to share with you guys some of my favorite lyrics from 2017. So yeah, without further ado, let's hop into the video.
My shadows dance without you for the first time. My heart is open. You walk right in tonight.
Too Much to Ask by Niall Horan. So growing up, I've always been at this dance studio called Cloudgate. As I got older, all of my classmates all quit because they needed to focus on their studies. Although I'm not a very good dancer, but I just love the idea of dancing. I just didn't stop until I had to. So my dance class went on until sophomore year or senior year in high school. Towards the end, I was put into this class where all of us are high schoolers. We all had the same goal. We had to work hard and apply for university. We also all had the same passion for dancing. There were 7 people in total. So we call ourselves the Big Dipper, which is a very, very funny nickname. I know this song is a love song, but to me, like before college started, when I was still in that dance studio, every time I danced, they were there with me. After graduating, we all went different directions, just like One Direction. Whenever I danced something that's similar to what I used to dance, or whenever I used the music that we used to use, I would always think of them because they were a huge part of my high school years. It just feels weird whenever you dance and they're not there with you. So that's why this song kind of spoke to me. You know, my shadow's dancing without you, just without you in general.
But you'll never be alone. I'll be with you from dusk till dawn. I'll be with you from dusk till dawn. Baby, I'm
ready. Dusk till dawn. When I was in high school, one of my friends told me that I'm the kind of person that when I see someone as a friend, I will give out 200% of my attention when they need me, no matter what time. If I see them as a friend, I would just drop everything and just help them in any way possible. That's just my personality. I'm not sure if it's a good trait or a bad trait because I used to have a very, very good friend. I'm not sure what she sees me. A burden, maybe. I got hurt pretty bad, so I'm not sure if this doing everything for your best friend is a very good personality trait, but that's just me. You'll never be alone, I'll be with you from dusk till dawn. Like, that's me when I see you as a friend. I would do anything for you. This personality gave me so many memories, good and bad. It's a huge part of me. So a song that kind of says who I am, gotta relate to it.
You should know you're beautiful just the way you are, and you don't have to change a thing.
This part of the lyrics, I think it's spreading a very important message. You don't have to change yourself to fit into the norm. Growing up, I realized that you don't have to change for anybody unless you're changing for the better. You have to become a better version of yourself, and then eventually you'll meet somebody who likes you for who you are, not likes you because of this weird modified personality that you created for them, because of course they're going to like them. If they like you for who you are, that's for your friendship right there. And I think that's kind of friendship worth fighting for.
I'm never gonna let you close to me, even though you mean the most to me, 'cause every time I open up it hurts.
For a few years, I was pretty depressed because a friend of mine in high school hurt me pretty bad. I was afraid to open up to anybody. To an extent, I feel like whenever I call somebody or text somebody, I'll be a burden. I don't want to let you close to me because every time I open up, it hurts. Yeah, that's pretty much my mindset for a few years. I was very depressed back then. I felt like I was not enough. I was so sad to an extent that I craved for that connection. You know, when you click with somebody, you feel that connection. I haven't felt that for years, but I'm so glad that I finally managed to find myself some friends, and I no longer have to be afraid to text somebody, to open up to somebody, because I know that they like me for who I am, maybe. I think they like me for who I am, and they're not going to hurt me like what my friend back in high school did. So yeah.
In my dreams, you will.
Every everybody who's had a crush on somebody will definitely relate. Because, well, of course, I've had crushes on people. And every time when I see them, I'll be like, yo, I like you, but nope. I'm going to message you on Facebook. I'm going to message you online. I'm just going to message you and just befriend you. And then that's all. I'm not going to do anything further than that. Yeah, I'm going to be single forever. It's like, in my dreams, you're with me. We'll be everything I want us to be. But in real life, nope. Let's not talk about my sad and depressing love life. Let's next song. If you saw my 27 video, you would know that last year was a huge year for me because I finally stepped out of my comfort zone and did things I never thought I would do. Stepping out of your comfort zone, finally putting yourself out there is terrifying, especially after you locked yourself in your own bubble for so many years. When I first started to make friends, I was horrified. Then I heard this song, the lyrics just hit me. It's like a wake-up call. It definitely pushed me into making new friends, no matter how uncomfortable it might be at first. Like, starting a conversation with someone you don't know? That's horrifying. That song pushed me into doing that, and now I'm in a very, very happy place, and I have to thank the song for that. It's like I got brand new eyes, and I can finally see what it's always been right there in front of me. And with these brand new eyes, I'll take in everything. I think this song, it's kind of like a mindset. It's kind of like escaping the tight grasp depression has on you. When you're finally able to treat yourself better, you no longer see the world as a horrifying place. The world is no longer black and white to you. You could finally let go of all that stress and pressure and finally see yourself for who you are and finally get to know yourself a little bit better. A song could mean different things to different people, but that's definitely how I interpreted the song. Yeah, finally stepping out, finally growing up. Finally getting the happiness and love you deserve. With that brand new eyes, you finally see all the opportunities and happiness and hope that has always been there. You just was too blinded by your sadness and depression. You weren't able to see that. I'm very, very glad that I finally snapped out of my own misery and was able to, you know, treat myself better. Yeah, we invent our own little games. When the light's out at the stadium, hey. When I first heard the song, the melody itself just was wow. I'm not sure what it means to Conan, but for me, the lyrics kind of mean like, you're afraid because you're leaving hometown for college. You're afraid of change. But after a while, you finally come to the terms that you and your friends are all going to be okay. No matter how much your town changes, it's not going to change that much. You're still going to recognize it when you come back. You're still going to feel this sense of home when you return once again. What I want to say about this song is don't be afraid of change, because every change in your life is either a challenge or either kind of like a turning point for you to reach another destination of your life. Who knows? It might bring you something very unexpected. But yeah, that's about it for my favorite lyrics of the year. I hope you guys enjoyed. Do you have a favorite song? And what's your favorite part of the lyrics from that song? I would love to know about that. So if you do, feel free to leave a comment down below so I could discover more beautiful songs with beautiful lyrics. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in another new video. Until next time. Bye. Let it all come crashing down.